Now, the last Yamo diagram of homonuclear diatomic molecule is that oxygen. That is Yamo diagram. Yamo diagram of O2 molecule. First of all, you have to write the electronic configuration of oxygen. The first part is that the electronic configuration of oxygen, that is atomic number of oxygen is 8, their proton configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p4. Second point, Yamo diagram of O2 molecule is, we can draw Yamo diagram very carefully and neatly if you draw the diagram very carefully, then you understand all the points very easily. Here to the left part we show the energy. Then here to the left atomic orbital of oxygen, one oxygen atom. Then to the right atomic orbital of other oxygen atom. In the middle portion of diagram, molecular orbitals of O2 molecule. Then 1s2. Then 2s2, we can join these lines in this way. The meaning of these lines is that atomic orbitals combine to form two types of molecular orbitals. One is bonding molecular orbital, its energy is lower than this for atomic orbitals. Energy of bonding molecular orbital is always lower than atomic orbitals or antibonding molecular orbitals, and energy of antibonding molecular orbital is higher than atomic orbitals or bonding molecular orbitals. Then 2p orbital, in 2p there are 3 orbitals, 2px, 2py and 2pz. There is one major difference is that in this case the energy level sequence is changed. In N2 or boron molecule, the energy level sequence is that first part 2pn, then part 2pn, part 2pz, then sigma 2px. In this case, sigma 2px, then part 2py and part 2pz. Join these lines. Here, no change means lines, and here antibonding molecular orbital of, this is pi star 2px, pi star 2p છે સિગ્મા સ્ટાર 2px. Then electrons are 2s 2 or 2s 2 and 2p 4. When two electrons are present, the electrons are filled like this or shown like this. Pointer is shown, half headed arrow in upper direction, and other electron shows half headed arrow in downward direction. In the same way, if there is only one electron, then it can show like this. 1s, 2s and 2p. Here 1s, 2s and 2p. The electrons are filled up. Here we can write KK or number 1s 2, then 2s 2, here sigma 2s, here sigma 2s. Sigma star will be antibonding molecular orbital. Electrons are filled like this. First of all, you have to count the number of electrons in 2p. There are 8 electrons, therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. Electrons are filled like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8th. In part 2PY and part 2PZ, you use Hund's rule. That is, electrons are filled singly first, then pairing. Once you should better understand the diagram, then you can write the points, where is the remaining points. That is first point. From the diagram, we say that atomic orbitals and molecular orbitals are arranged in the increasing order of their energy. 1s, then 2s, then 2p. 1s, 2s, 2p. Then KK, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, sigma 2px, part 2py, part 2pz, part star 2px, part star 2pz. Then lastly, sigma star 2px. Second point. Atomic orbitals are shown to the two sides of the diagram. Means atomic orbital of one atom, one oxygen atom shows to the left of this diagram, and atomic orbital of other oxygen atom shows to the right side of this diagram. Molecular orbitals are shown in the middle of the diagram. Here, atomic orbitals combine to form molecular orbitals. They lose their identity except 1s, because 1s orbital electrons do not take part in bonding. Simply, they are transferred to the molecular orbitals, but they remain same as in atomic orbitals. Then, fourth point, the electrons are filled in molecular orbitals according to above principle, Pauli exclusion principle and Hund's rule. We have told you that above principle means electrons are filled in the increasing order of their energy. Pauli exclusion principle means no two electrons in an atom can have the same set of quantum numbers, means their spin quantum number are very different. One electron has spin quantum number spin in clockwise direction, and other electron spins in anticlockwise direction. Therefore, their spin quantum number is different. Hamming rule means electrons are filled singly, then single pass, then pair. Then from this diagram we write the electronic configuration of O2 molecule is equal to KK, then sigma 2s2 sigma star 2s2 sigma 2px2 pi 2py2 is equal to pi 2pz2 and pi star 2px1 is equal to pi star 2py1. One electron present in pi star 2px and pi star 2pz. Therefore, the electron configuration of O2 molecule is like this. In this case, 2s and 2p orbitals. In case of boron, carbon and nitrogen, and in case of oxygen, fluorine. In case of boron, carbon and nitrogen, lower energy difference between 2s and 2p orbitals or lower effective nuclear charge allows the mixing of 2s and 2p orbitals. But in case of oxygen and fluorine, there is larger effective nuclear charge and large energy difference between 2s and 2p orbitals. Therefore, no mixing of 2s and 2p orbitals is not allowed in O2 and F2. This is the reason behind it. High energy level sequence of MO molecular orbitals is written in case of oxygen and in case of oxygen in case of nitrogen. Then third point, bond order NB minus NA upon 2. NB means number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital. NA means number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals. Bonding molecular orbitals are 2, 6, 8. 8 minus antibonding 2 minus 2, 4 is equal to 8 minus antibonding 2 plus 2, 4 upon 2, or simply we consider this part. Bonding molecular orbital 6, 6 minus 2, 6 minus 2 upon 2, here 4 upon 2, here 4 upon 2, therefore bond order is 2. The bond order of O2 molecule is 2. We already told you that if bond order is 1 or greater than 1, then molecule exists. Therefore, in this case also, bond order of oxygen molecule is 2. Therefore, it shows that oxygen molecule, O2 molecule exists. And there are 2 covalent bonds between 2 O atoms. Out of these 2, one is sigma 1, another is pi 1. Therefore, here bond length increases, bond length decreases. Number of pi bonds increases, bond length decreases. Therefore, bond dissociation energy also increases. Means, fourth point, as bond order is 2, O2 molecule exists and there are 2 covalent bond between 2 O atoms. One is sigma bond, another is pi bond. Then stability. Stability, if bond order is 1 or greater than 1, molecule is always stable. Therefore, here bond order is 2. Therefore, stability of the molecule is stable molecule. Means oxygen molecule is stable molecule. Fifth one, magnetic character already we told you that if one or more electrons are paired, one or more electrons are unpaired in molecular orbitals, then molecule is paramagnetic. If all electrons are present in the molecular orbitals, therefore molecule is diamagnetic. If we can see the diagram, in this case molecular orbital is unpaired, therefore molecule is, magnetic character of this molecule is paramagnetic. Therefore oxygen molecule is paramagnetic. In this way we can explain all the MO diagrams of homonuclear diatomic molecules. That is, first one is Hu2 molecule, second one is Li2 molecule, third one is B2 molecule, fourth one is N2 molecule, and fifth one is O2 molecule. Then in the next period we see that how to draw the MO diagrams of heteronuclear diatomic molecules. In this year the syllabus committee included the two points, that is CO and NO. C and O, these are the two different atoms. N and O, these are the two different atoms. And how to draw these diagrams, it can see in the next video. Thank you.